Today in the Rhode Show kitchen, two of my favorite guys are here, TV Maitre D, Joe Zito, chef and owner of the Post Office Cafe,
yes.
The new Post Office Cafe, I should say, John Granata. Welcome back, guys.
Good morning. Thank you
very much.
Congrats. I hear it's been a great couple of weeks.
Yeah, no, things are great.
It's fabulous.
I'm very happy.
Good.
Very happy.
Good to hear.
Tell it like it is. It's great.
It's great.
Yeah.
Well,
it really
is. Yeah, and we welcome everyone to go down there and check out John's new place, especially too for the food.
Yeah.
And if it's anything like what we've got on the menu today, you're in good hands. What do we have?
We are doing a fall dish which we call Pappardelle.
Autunno. Yeah.
Which
autumn
is
pasta.
An autumn pasta.
Yum.
It's beautiful. Yeah.
So we have some fresh pappardelle, which is the extra wide noodles.
I love those.
You can actually make those homemade if you want.
Or
kale,
out of the box.
Or you can buy them.
Yeah, you can do it that way.
Fresh kale. This is baby Tuscan kale.
Mm-hmm.
Butternut squash, which we roasted,
okay. Cubed
up. We have pork belly, which is probably the star of the show. And I'll go through basically how you can do pork belly.
Okay.
And we have walnuts, butter, and Parmesan cheese. Basically, what we're going to do is make a brown butter sauce. And I'm going to show you how to do that because it's the only part of the dish that you really got to pay attention.
Okay.
Very good.
Perfect.
Sound good?
Everything else.
A little vino.
You can be a little distracted.
You have to
you
pay
have
attention to that, too. Sure.
We've got wine. We've got delicious ingredients, too. And really pretty healthy for the most part. The kale, the butternut squash.
Yeah.
You're incorporating some good ingredients.
Yep. Optimum time of the year for this stuff. And so it's, you know, you're going to get it all fresh.
Perfect. Fantastic. Sounds great. We're going to get things started in just a bit.
That's right. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen, the TV Maitre D, Joe Zito, also over here, chef, owner of the new Post Office Cafe, John Granata. We've got some great stuff. He's very busy. He's mixing. What do you want to do right now?
I want to show you a couple of things. First of all, we're going to, the base of this sauce is called the brown butter.
Mm-hmm.
And you want to heat the pan up just ever so slightly, but you want to be careful not to burn the butter. So you want to keep it going.
Okay.
I'm going to use, I know it looks like an enormous amount of butter, but we're looking at probably close to 2 sticks of butter.
All right.
Now, at the same time, what we're doing here is we're going to keep it on medium heat. We're going to infuse some flavors into it. When we say infuse, basically what we're going to do is we're going to place the flavor right into the butter. All right. So I got 2 cloves of garlic, and I got a little sprig of thyme.
Thyme.
And while that goes, we're going to just watch it. You cannot, it's vital that you don't walk away from this.
Burn the butter.
You don't want to burn the butter?
No.
No. And right before it starts to turn brown, we're going to put the walnuts in.
Okay.
But I want to talk really quickly about pork belly. So pork belly, what I did was I cubed up some pork belly that we already cooked. Pork belly is back bacon that is not cured or smoked.
Okay.
Okay? So you can buy this at the market. It looks disgusting. It's all fat, it seems like. But what you're going to do is you're going to score it. You're going to place it in the oven for about an hour and a half. Cook it at 350 or lower. Herbs, olive oil, sea salt, whatever you want to do to it. But whatever you do, you're going to cook it long and slow. And when it goes out, you're going to let it cool, and you're going to dice it up into pieces. And you're going to we're going to show you in the next segment how we're going to brown it back up.
Okay. All right. So this is good stuff. All right. So we're going to let this simmer just for a little while. Put all this stuff together. It seems like a great recipe, a delicious recipe.
I'll make sure he doesn't burn it.
Don't
while we're
let
away.
Him. Don't
no.
let him burn it.
So
don't
I'm gonna walk away. Now.
No, you're
don't
not.
Don't let him burn it. And then our TV Maitre D, Joe Zito's got some great wine to suggest to go along with us. And then yes, we're gonna talk about the brand new Post Office Cafe in Main Street. We'll get to that. Back to you.
Pappardelle with butternut squash, pork belly, and baby kale is on the menu. TV Maitre D, Joe Zito, chef. And owner of the new Post Office Cafe,
he didn't
John Granata.
Burn the butter.
Okay.
Or the nuts.
Oh, good to know.
We put 2 sticks of butter in the pan, right? We want to put it on a medium heat. What I did was I infused the fresh thyme and the garlic. Now we can take the garlic out and we put we put the walnuts in.
Okay.
All right. So you're going
to
take the thyme right out.
Not to burn them.
And,
really.
And believe me, this is extremely hot. So don't
go reaching in there.
Right.
Let your kids help you with another step.
So we can turn this up just a bit because now it's starting to brown. You see it?
Yeah.
See, it's starting to turn.
But not burning.
But what you're getting is a nutty flavor from the butter automatically.
That's great.
And you're
great.
Adding nuts to it. So
so
now what we're going to do is we're going to put the butternut squash in.
It smells.
And that's going to cool the temperature down just a bit. And the pork belly. Now the pork belly, which we said in the last segment, basically what we do is we buy the pork belly. We cook it for about an hour and a half on a 350 oven. Herbs, a little bit of olive oil and sea salt, and just let it do its thing.
Eat it just like that?
Absolutely.
Okay.
I'm telling you, great boss snack.
All right.
A little pork belly in your belly, you'll be set for the day.
Right?
Oh, wow.
Look at that. Now, okay.
Okay, so now we get that going in there. So we're going to throw the baby kale in there.
Yum.
All fresh.
All right.
Beautiful.
So this is what's going on here. And that's basically your dish.
Okay.
The pappardelle is cooking. And then we're going to toss it with a little pecorino romano, salt, and pepper.
That's like okay, the hot veggie for 2015, kale.
I love kale.
Oh, yeah.
New superfood.
It's delicious. So we're going to let that kind of wilt down just for a minute. And while we do, we got to get to this wine.
Of course. Well, one of my favorite wineries is in the Napa Valley, and it's Francis Ford Coppola's wine, mm-hmm. right there off Route 29. You go to the winery there, you see the old Godfather desk from the movie. It's just a
great place.
This is their Diamond Collection. This is their signature series. Chardonnay, and I love this wine. I love it with this dish, but what I love about this is very fruit forward, tropical fruits, but if you pour it into the glass, it's a very deep yellow color. You really don't get cheated with this wine. With all these flavors, it'll stand up to it beautifully.
You don't want to cheat when you're making this
recipe.
No,
it's only about a $14 bottle of wine, but it's beautiful. It's a little notch up from their regular Rosso and Bianco that you may see. This is a beautiful Chardonnay,
nice.
And you love this very much. And I am a big fan of this. And a nice gift wine to take to someone, too.
Beautiful. I'm a big fan of wine. I'm a big fan of good food. And that's what's over at the new Post Office Cafe.
You can serve that to your friends and your enemies.
And your enemies. But make a wine you can't refuse, Michaela.
Now, new Post Office Cafe has been doing great.
Fabulous. Yeah. And you know what it is? It's the ambiance. It is the food.
Mm-hmm.
It's for dinner 6 nights a week. They're closed Mondays, but we're coming up on the holiday season. But what John and his wife Sherry and all of their good friends did with the ambiance and the renovations is spectacular. It's just beautiful. It's very comfortable. Mm-hmm. And it's just the perfect location right there in East Greenwich on Main Street.
Yeah,
fabulous.
It's great. And you know, we have a lot of great restaurants in our area and even new stuff that maybe not.
Well, let me tell you what. Everybody knows I love the Post Office Cafe and I love this guy. But I've been associated with a place that's spectacular that just opened. But I've been on board for 6 months consulting with these nice people at Prime Cut Modern Steakhouse in Providence. There's nothing like this in Rhode Island. It's a 75-seat upscale steakhouse. Fabulous food.
Yeah.
Executive Chef Guy Charles, a fabulous staff, and I urge people to come down. I spent a lot of time there. I'd like them to come down and say hello to me. And then there's Mezzo Ultra Lounge just next door. So it's an evening out, even, you know, for somebody like you. I mean, come on.
Well,
so please, there's two great restaurants.
I don't know, with a recipe like this, it might be an evening you can enjoy that and some a bottle of wine. But it's all about balance, right?
So let's look at what we got here. We got the pappardelle.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's
beautiful. We have the butternut squash.
All
we have the pork belly. We have the crunchy walnuts.
Looks
and we have the kale. And
different
you see,
textures coming together. And easy enough, it all can, you know, comes in one pan, easy cleanup.
Right.
I cannot wait to sample this.
It's even easier when you let somebody else do it.
There you go. I'm going to let it cool off for just a second. But if you want this recipe, head on over to roadshow.com. He won't wait.
Mm-hmm.